Hey, what's going on everyone? Josh Quinones here, and in this video, I'm gonna be doing a little 4K video test between the Galaxy S20 Ultra and my new Sony ZV-1. Okay, so I think I have a little over 500 videos now posted to the channel, and a little over 500 of those videos have actually all been recorded on a smartphone up until recently when I got my new Sony ZV-1, which I think recorded maybe the past 3 or 4 videos. But since then, I've actually gotten a lot of good feedback on the quality of this camera, and some people actually thought that I was still filming on my smartphone. I had to tell them, no, I'm actually filming on the Sony ZV-1. But in this video, I wanna compare the two, and I want you guys to be the judge. I wanna get your opinion on just how much better the quality is coming from a smartphone. Was it actually worth it to go out and purchase the Sony ZV-1, or should I have stuck with my smartphone? I wanna get your guys' opinion. I really, really wanna know. Me personally, I think that quality has definitely improved with the Sony ZV-1 coming from a smartphone, but who knows, some of you might not even notice a difference. Maybe you think the smartphone quality is a bit better than the Sony ZV-1, I don't know. But like I said, I'm gonna let you all be the judge down in the comment sections below. So let's go ahead and get this test started, starting with the Samsung Galaxy S20 Ultra. Boom, we are now on the front facing camera of the Galaxy S20 Ultra. As you can see, got my Note 10 Plus in hand. What do you guys think? How does the quality look? How do I look? How does the background look? I am using some natural lighting coming from the window right here, and then I have a small ring light here to my right just to kind of help out with the lighting. Now, I am using an external mic plugged into the phone at the moment since we are inside doing this inside test first before we head outside, because it could get a bit echoey in this room. But when we get outside, I'll make sure to use the internal mics on the phone and the camera as well. But you guys, let me know what you think of the overall quality. And then of course, if you do like the sound quality of this video, I'll make sure to have a link to that mic down in the description below. But this is the front-facing camera on the Galaxy S20 Ultra. Let's go ahead and switch it up to the rear-facing camera. All right, so we are now on the rear-facing camera of the Galaxy S20 Ultra, where you're gonna get your best video quality coming from the front-facing camera. What do you guys think? How do I look? How does the background look? Again, same inside setting. We got the natural light coming from the window and then a small ring light here to my right. What do you guys think about the overall quality? Let me go ahead and show a product here, see how well that comes up. Does it blur out my face? Does it concentrate on the product, or does it pretty much focus on everything? I can't really see. That's the only downside to recording on a rear-facing camera on any smartphone, is that you can't see yourself compared to when you're recording with the front-facing camera. And that is one advantage that the Sony ZV-1 has compared to recording with the rear-facing camera on a smartphone. This has a flip-out screen. So if I were to flip the screen out like this, I can see myself. If I want to vlog or just set the camera up, do a little talking to the camera, I can see myself. And then if I want to turn the camera around, I can just move the flip screen back and I can still see what I'm recording. Now, again, that's the only downside to recording with a rear-facing camera on a smartphone. And one thing that makes it difficult in the beginning of recording your video, because when I would record my videos with the smartphone, I was constantly having to go back and forth, just to make sure I was in frame before actually starting the video. So that's kind of one downside. But other than that, what do you guys think about the overall quality? Once again, let's go ahead and check out the Sony ZV-1. All right, so we are now on the Sony ZV-1. What do you guys think about the overall quality? How do I look? Do I look more detailed, clear, and crisp coming from the Galaxy S20 Ultra? Again, same inside setting, same natural lighting coming from the window here, same ring light to my right over here. What do you guys think about the overall quality? A couple things I like better about recording on this camera rather than the rear-facing camera on a smartphone is, first of all, I can see myself. I actually have this flip-out screen, so I'm not having to go back and forth to make sure I'm in frame. I can move as far as I want to the right, still knowing I'm in frame, as far as I want to the left. I can stand up knowing that my head is cut off. So this is one huge thing that I like better about recording on this camera rather than the rear-facing camera on a smartphone. Another thing is a defocus mode. So all I gotta do is just press this button up here once and boom, it blurs out the background, still keeps me focused, giving it a nice professional look. This is a mode that I really like using. Now, the smartphones have kind of a feature like this. It's called live focus video mode on both the Galaxy S20 Ultra and Note 10 Plus, but it is nowhere near what this looks like. Honestly, I would never use that mode on those smartphones. That's just my own personal opinion. I think this looks a whole lot better. Another mode that this camera has that I really, really like is the product showcase mode. So I was back looking at the footage on the Galaxy S20 Ultra where I was showing you guys my Note 10 Plus, and I noticed it didn't focus on the phone. It stayed focused on my face. Now, the product showcase mode on this camera will allow you to show products without staying focused on your face. Instead, it will focus on the product. So if I move this up close to the camera, look at that. Blurs out my face and focuses on the product. Let's do it again. Boom. And look how fast that focuses. Boom. Take it away, focuses on me. Put it back up. Boom. Boom. I could do this all day. Boom. One more time. Boom. Look at that. I think this feature is something that's great for people like me, tech reviewers, or any type of person that reviews a product on YouTube. This is something great to use with this camera. You don't have to worry about covering your face like this and then showing the product so it focuses on the product rather than your face. I think this is a perfect feature to have in your camera, and I think more cameras that come out in the future should have this feature. But again, this is all about quality between this camera and the smartphone. What do you guys think so far? Let me know down in the comments. Let's go ahead and head outside and see what that looks like. All right, so I have made my way outside, as you can see here, and whoo, it is hot out here, which I guess is kind of a good thing because I don't really have to worry about running into anybody. There's like literally nobody out here at this park right now. So currently filming on the rear-facing camera of the Galaxy S20 Ultra. What do you guys think? I figure since the rear-facing camera gives you the best quality when recording 4K video, I'm just gonna go ahead and use this and compare it to the Sony ZV-1. So what do you guys think so far? I got the sun facing directly in my face right now. Ooh, I'll go ahead and pan around here a little bit. Now, I can't really see if I'm fully in frame, so I'm sorry if I'm not. Hopefully my head's not cut off or anything like that. Let's go ahead and check out video stabilization. Go ahead and do a little bit of jogging here. There we go. What do you guys think? You can hear a bunch of bugs. I'm not sure if you guys can hear the bugs or not, but there's a bunch of those. What do you call them? I'm not really sure what they're called. The cicadas. You can hear a bunch of them going on right now. Really, really annoying. But what do you guys think about the mic quality as well? I am going to be using the internal mics on both of these, the camera and the Galaxy S20 Ultra. I'll do one more pan around here, and then we'll take a look at the Sony ZV-1. Let me know what you guys think. All right, so I am now on the Sony ZV-1. As you can see, got my Galaxy S20 Ultra in hand. What do you guys think? What do you guys think? Do you see a huge difference coming from the cameras on the Galaxy S20 Ultra? Just gonna pan around here a little bit now. I do wanna point out that I am using the built-in ND filter that this camera has, and I am using the defocus mode to give it more of a professional look, blur out that background and keep me in focus, because I mean, this camera has it, so why not use it? I mean, like I said earlier in the video, you can do things with the cameras on the Galaxy S20 Ultra to kind of tweak with it a little bit and kind of give it this effect, but you are definitely not going to get the same results as what I am getting right now. So what do you guys think? Please excuse me if I am starting to sweat like crazy here. Like I said, it is hot out here, but let's go ahead and check out stabilization. I do have the active mode turned on. So just gonna do a little bit of jogging here. And I'm just using little small handheld tripods like this. There we go. What do you guys think? Also, let me know how well the mic is picking up my voice. I do have the wind filter on here. Let me know if it's picking up any of that background sound. Like I said, the bugs are buzzing really loud in these trees over here. So I'll go ahead and pan around one more time. And then after this, I'm gonna go and take some more footage with both cameras. That way you guys aren't having to look at my face the whole time. So I'm gonna go right now, take some more footage with both cameras, play them back to back so you can really compare the two when it comes to filming in certain situations. So go ahead and enjoy. Thank you.
So there it is, a little 4K video comparison between the Sony ZV-1 and the Galaxy S20 Ultra. What do you guys think about overall video quality between these two? Do you think one was better than the other, or do you think they were pretty much on par with each other? Let me know down in the comment sections below. I would love to know what you guys think. Like I said, I'm gonna let you all be the judge of this video in deciding which one was better than the other, or like I said, maybe you think they're both just about the same. Let me know down in the comments. Thank you guys so very much for watching. If you did like this video, leave a huge thumbs up. If you did find it helpful, I hope I was able to help somebody out in deciding on whether you should choose a smartphone or the Sony ZV-1 to start your YouTube channel. Or maybe if you have a YouTube channel, you're looking for a new camera or possibly a new phone with a better camera. I hope this video was able to help you out. But like I said, leave a huge thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell for notifications so you don't miss out on any other future videos to come. Thanks again for watching. This is Josh Quinones. I will see you on the next one. Peace out.